世界のみんな、おはよう世界。ということで、今回はゲッティングオーバーイット、通称ツボ男ですね。これをやっていこうと思うんやけど、皆さんこれ知ってます？このゲーム。このゲームはいわゆるクソゲーと言われてて、あ、死ぬんやこれ。こう通称まあクソゲーなんですけども、これはクソ難しいゲームで、本来クソゲーやったらめちゃくちゃおもんないとかなんですけど、これ面白いんですよ。でもやばい、もう発狂するレベルに難しいゲームなんですよね、これ。今回僕の動画を見て気になって、気に入っていただけるんやったら、もうこれ何倍やったかな、300円なんですけど、ネットでもあるんで、パソコンでも、元が PC 版なんですけど、スマホ版でも今回あるんで、ぜひともまたお買い求めいただければと思うんですけど、今回はこのゲームを5分でどれだけ進めるのかっていう、僕の実力でっていうのをやっていこうと思うんですけど、もう見てて分かるんですけど、これ指で動かすんですけど、この黒い丸見えますかね、この黒い丸、これをこれがまあだから基準になって、こう引っ掛けてこう登ったりすることができるんですよ。こうやって移動して。
There's no feeling more intense than starting over. If you deleted your homework the day before it was due, as I have, or if you left your wallet at home and you have to go back after spending an hour in the commute, if you won some money at the casino and then put all your winnings on red but it came up black, if you got your best shirt dry cleaned before a wedding and then immediately dropped food on it, if you won an argument with a friend and then later discovered that they just returned to their original view.Starting over is harder than starting up. If you're not ready for that, like if you've already had a bad day, then what you're about to go through might be too much. Feel free to go away and come back. I'll be here.
これも難しいからできないんですよね。で、例えば引っかかるだけじゃなく、こう飛んで見せて引っかかって飛ぶみたいなこともできるんですよね。でこういう引っかかった部分などを斧で引っ掛けて、あおっていう風になんかこれ厄介なんですよ。とりあえず操作性が難しくて、これ 今から5分ですかね。これが中
途。All right. Thanks for coming with me on this trip. I'll understand if you have to take a break at any point. Just find a safe place to stop and quit the game. Don't worry. I'll save your progress always.Even your mistakes.
じゃあ、用意、スタートということで、今から測っていこうと思います。あと10秒で5分になるんで、そこから測っていこうと思います。緊張するな。用意、スタート。OK。おお、これタイムアタックのどこまでいけるかっていうゲームは、こんな引っかかってたらマジで。
This game is a homage to a free game that came out in 2002, titled Sexy Hiking. The author of that game is Jazua, a mysterious Czech designer who was known at the time as the father of B games. And B games are rough assemblages of found objects. Designers slap them together very quickly and freely, and they're often too rough and unfriendly to gain much of a following. They're built more for the joy of building them than as polished products.In a certain way, Sexy Hiking is the perfect embodiment of a B game. It's built almost entirely out of found and recycled parts, and it's one of the most unusual and unfriendly games of its time. In it, your task is simply to drag yourself up a mountain with a hammer. And that act of climbing, in the digital world or in real life, has certain essential properties that give the game its flavor. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed.Some cliffs are too sheer or too slippery, and the player is constantly, unremittingly in danger of falling and losing everything. Oh, you just lost a lot of progress. That's a deep frustration, a real punch in the gut.
いけてないか、これいけてないか。ここで落ち着いて。あ、 もう最悪。Oof,
sorry about that.
え、さっきもう3分経ってんのか。やばない。落ち着いて。落ち着いて。一本集中。一本集中じゃねえ。よいしょ。よいしょ。やばい、あと1分やで。来た。
Anyway, when you start sexy hiking, you're standing next to this dead tree that blocks the way to the entire rest of the game. It might take you an hour to get over that tree, and a lot of people never got past it. You prod and you poke at it, exploring the limits of your reach and your strength, trying to find a way up and over.And there's a sense of truth in that lack of compromise. Most obstacles in video game worlds are fake. You can be completely confident in your ability to get through them once you have the correct method or the correct equipment or just by spending enough time. In that sense, every pixelated
はい、検証結果では私サウスはスタート地点から5分間でどこまで進めるのかという検証結果は、スタート地点のままということです。やば、そんなに下手やったか。1ヶ月ぶりにやったの。では今回の動画はここでおしまいです。また次の動画をお楽しみください。ありがとうございました。Intended to make a frustrating game. The frustration is just essential to the act of climbing, and it's authentic to the process of building a game of that kind. A funny thing happened to me as I was building this mountain. I had an idea for a new obstacle, and I built it, tested it, and it would usually turn out to be unreasonably hard. But I couldn't bring myself to make it easier. It already felt like my inability to get past the new obstacle was my fault as a player rather than as a builder. Imaginary mountains build themselves from their efforts to climb them, and it's our repeated attempts to reach the summit that turns those mountains into something real. When you're building a video game world, you're building with ideas, and that can be like working with quicksand cement. You want an idea to set in shape, and you play with it, and you press the climb button, and it gets hard and you set.
For years now, people have been predicting that games would soon be made out of prefabricated objects, bought in a store and assembled.